I'd like to take some time to talk to you about inverted nipple repair. What is inverted nipple repair? What are inverted nipples? Well, if you found this video, you may have inverted nipples or know someone with inverted nipples. Inverted nipples are simply the presence of a depression in the area where the nipple is, central to the areola. This is a developmental process whereby the nipples don't fully come out of the nipple complex during development. And it can be caused by many different issues of development. And it's treated with a very simple approach. Classically, the approach for inverted nipple repair was to make an incision between the base of the nipple and the areola and to go underneath and cut everything that's there, including the ducts and the connective tissue that's pulling the nipple in. An approach that I like to utilize is a duct-sparing surgery, where we make an incision at the base of the nipple and then separate the fibrous tissue while preserving and identifying the ducts in order to hopefully provide for breastfeeding in the future and to prevent obstruction of the ducts down the line. This is important because many women that come for this procedure are young and they're self-conscious and they haven't had children just quite yet. Now, it's important to understand that about 30% of women in general in the population will have difficulty with breastfeeding whether or not they have inverted nipples or whether or not they've had a repair. And so it's difficult to predict who's going to have difficulty breastfeeding in general. But you know, this approach is designed to preserve the physiologic movement of milk from the glands to the nipple and to deliver it to the child. Now, this approach is something that I've written several different articles on. The first article is from 9 years ago with 127 patients. And more recently, we've done many more articles focusing on the public's perception of inverted nipples and their repair. What we know from these articles and from all the research that I've written, the science that I've published on this, is that number one, it is a real problem. A lot of physicians will tell their patient, it's not a big deal, it's not a big problem, it doesn't cause you an issue. But we do see that women that have inverted nipples are extremely embarrassed or feel shy about those nipples. And they also feel self-conscious when they take off their clothes or even in a bathing suit or t-shirt. So it is something that you should discuss with your provider. And if your OBGYN or your pediatrician hasn't seen the literature on it or hasn't seen videos on it, they may not know that there are these procedures out there to improve the nipple projection. And I would ask that you share the video with them and the research on this topic. But in the articles that I've written in the literature for OBGYNs, for pediatricians, we've focused on the fact that this surgery does improve patients' perception of their own bodies. And we know from our patients that many women after surgery are able to breastfeed, and many women do feel like it's given them a dramatic improvement for their body. Now, not all inverted nipples are the same. Flat nipples or nipples that lack projection are not as good of a nipple to operate on as compared to nipples that are truly inverted, where there's a lot of nipple inside the breast. We can improve the projection of those nipples. They do get better, but they may require additional procedures, including injection with a small amount of filler or additional surgical procedures down the line. No surgery is without complications. Certainly these surgeries have their issues. The main issue is simply just that after surgery, you have to wear a stent that keeps the nipple averted. And there are some sutures that take some time to heal and have to come out at a later time point. But in most patients, the results are durable, patients are happy, and there's not another surgery needed. We'll talk more about the risks of surgery and what to expect before, during, and after during our virtual consultation, where we go over your goals, we talk about your nipples, your breasts, and ultimately the procedure that you need to undergo to improve your shape and to give you better self-confidence and to improve the way that you look.